Our idea of the movie was that it was going to take place in a landscape that was like Gypsy House, which is Dahl's house, that part of England.
He loved the countryside. He loved the woods. They go right through his books, and of course, particularly in Fantastic Mr. Fox.
We take the shortcut or the scenic route?
Let's take the shortcut.
Oh, but the scenic route is so much prettier.
Okay, let's take the scenic route.
Wes came to Gypsy House, and then he said, would you mind if I came and stayed to write the screenplay? He said, I think I'll feel the atmosphere. And I said, no, I'd be delighted.
I started working with Noah Baumbach on the script, and I had an idea of where it could start. We just followed it through.
I think his books are perfect for making into films. We have the most enchanting notebook that Roald did and illustrated himself. He had the foxes pushing the supermarket trolleys. All those things moved Wes.
And a lot of the details of his life sort of found their way into our story and into his character.
I'm going to tape this for my records, so don't make a lot of sounds. Meaning stop rocking.
Dahl probably wrote Mr. Fox to be an animal version of himself. As a result of that, Dahl is a very interesting man, and so that went into the character.
Here we are. Wow.
He's copied everything. Wes had every lampshade, every object in the house photographed, and had little miniatures made of them. God, what a team they had. The first time I went, I just burst into tears. I mean, it was so emotional for me because they'd caught so many of Roald's characteristics, which are slightly in Mr. Fox, and just an atmosphere of what he was trying to create in the book.
Honey, I'm 7 non-Fox years old now. My father died at 7 and a half. I don't want to live in a hole anymore. And I'm going to do something about it.
My breath was taken away, I have to say. It's fantastic. I can feel him smiling. When I was watching it, I thought, he'd love this.
I love you, Felicity.
I love you too.